Suffolk farmer Peter Mortimer has been keeping pigs for more than 50 years. As well as running a successful business, he's won numerous awards for his livestock and he's well respected by other farmers. But he's selling off his sows, forced to quit the industry, he says, by a combination of soaring input costs, low pig prices, and a lack of government action to resolve a labour shortage across the pig sector.
Just at the present moment, I feel that if I could get rid of the whole lot out of the way tomorrow, I'd be a lot happier. We've got down to the last 30, 40 sows, but if I could just get rid of the whole lot, I'd be a lot happier, because all the way down is right across the industry for everybody. We're just racking up losses, that's the trouble. I should think probably 10, 15 pounds a pig at the moment, but see, last week the price went down 5 pence a kilogram. All these issues we've had over the labour issue, the Brexit issue, the gas issue, and the abattoir not being able to do this, that, the other, and cut it, is they're not the farmer's problem. But who's paying the bill for everything that's gone wrong up the front? The farmer has had to take the debt. And that is, they should be sharing it out. But the unfortunate thing is, of course, since we started to slaughter these pigs out, the sows in June, all the prices done have started to go down. It's horrendous. Now the whole situation's got horrendous. Where we go from here, I don't know. I say, you know, I think, quite honestly, we thought the last 6-9 months was bad, but we've got all these pigs piled up on farms, and they've got people, as they tell me now, starting to kill piglets off because there's not a home for them. The final straw was that we had 2 staff leave at different times. We were advertising the local newspaper. Spent £125 one weekend to put adverts in the local newspaper, but I got no replies at all. My abattoir said he could do with 8 or 10 butchers more. Then he could obviously cut the meat into primals and sell more like that. But nobody seems to want a job if it involves getting your hands dirty. They all want to keep their hands clean. There's not many of us that are left that are actually independent farmers. And what's going to happen going forward, I hate to think.